Hey, it's Necktie. Welcome to episode 121 of Road to 5 Million. And in this one, we're headed to Powder River, Wyoming with some sand. Let's get into it. And if you remember the end of the last episode, I kind of destroyed Karen, so she's in the shop getting fixed. And we're back in the Piz Termiting 389X. As I said, I warned you I would have to switch trucks because I destroyed Big Karen. Well, didn't destroy her, but you know what I mean. You saw it. So it put me in Lake County. And we're taking this load of sand to Powder River, which I haven't picked up yet. We have to go do. And once we pick it up, I'm going to adjust the route and see how long it is to come through here so we can pick up Rock River, since we don't have that one picked up yet. So that is the plan. That and not to destroy anything. I'll shut up and get moving. I also don't know why your brakes aren't applied when you fast travel somewhere, but anyway. And in case you didn't see, we have the Pizzer Tempty back as well. Oh, one other thing I did to the truck. If you notice, it's a little shorter. So I have the 205 inch wheelbase instead of the 305. Something a little different. All my other trucks are stretched out, so I figured, you know, we'd go back to normal on this one. Or what you would typically see out there, I guess. Oh, we got a nice little greenhouse. I must sell those tomatoes or something, because I don't eat them. Management does, though, so maybe that's why we have them. Although, she doesn't eat that many tomatoes. Huh? I swear she's drinking sometimes.
You have reached your destination.
So I don't know if those that have been paying attention, that prompt that just popped up, I was wondering why I wasn't getting that. I had it unchecked in the settings, that's why. But what that would allow me to do is if I wanted to skip the loading process and just hit the button, it would automatically load me and basically put me in that spot right there. So, just the way this trailer reacted, I honestly think there's an issue with that step deck that I used the last couple of episodes. Now, this angle is off because I did that. But it's actually responding even to minute movements. Now another thing I'd really like to test, but I'm not going to take a lot of time to do it, is the how straight I am in that mirror. Okay, so according to my mirrors, the truck is lined up and I should be damn near dead center in this spot. So after we load, we will check. Okay, well the spot's gone because I loaded, but that's pretty damn straight. So interesting. I'll have to keep an eye on that, but yeah, as I'm looking at my mirrors, I'm... So maybe it's not the FOV thing that I was talking about. It could be the Ruta trucks as well, because I don't know if you noticed, but see how clear that driver's side mirror is? Rutas aren't like that. So that could be part of the issue as well. Like some pixelation throwing it off, I guess. I don't know. Nothing huge, just something, you know, that bugs someone like me. I was wondering why this is pulling so hard, and then I realized that it's 101,000 pounds of sand. Sidetracked on the being straight and didn't check the map. So I will do that when I hit the stop sign here. All right, so that says 471. What if we do this? Total trip distance 480. So a whopping 9 miles difference. Plus we've already been on this. All right, perfect. Oh, brakes time. Changes for those keeping up with everything in the config file or anything when it has to do with the average window length. So blinkers may or may not speed up. I have no idea. But the gameplays seem to be relatively smooth, so if I have to put up with a little blinker speed up here and there, I'm just gonna leave it. I did remember to double check the classic AI traffic pack by Jazzy Cat. And I took it out of my main, or my test profile slash main profile, whatever the hell you want to call it. But I forgot to take it out of this one. So I did take that out. tie. Need to slow down a little sooner. Yeah, other than that, not much to catch you up on. It's Sunday as I record this, and I had a did a live stream, which started out interesting, but it was a learning experience because we had the... I may have mentioned it before. If I haven't, I am now, that Ruta makes the classic X. When you buy the Freight Shaker Classic XL, you get two versions of it. One for ATS, one for ETS. So we had that in the stream today, which meant updating files. And then Chris busted his ass this morning and got the ATS paint scheme over to ETS for that truck. And in the process of updating files, he couldn't connect to the convoy because the game was saying two of the files were not the same, basically. Which they were the same exact version. The only problem was when I shared the files with him, the OpenDef, when I drug it to Discord and shared it with them, instead of spaces between words, it puts an underscore. Well, when you put that in your mod folder, if... So bottom line is, the mods had the exact same name, words. It's just his had underscores instead of spaces. And the game said they weren't the same version. And it took us probably 10 minutes before I realized what the issue was, and then everything went fine. Ran a load. Two loads or one load? No, the one load was really long. Bottom line is, at the 2 hour and 53 minute mark, everything was going fine. Oh, I forgot to mention, too, prior to Chris busting his ass to get the mod updated, he was having internet issues. So even getting connected was kind of iffy at the time. But anyway, everything worked out great. Had a great stream. People were enjoying it. And then at the 2 hour and 53 minute mark, I'm driving along and I see... it said that he disconnected from the convoy, and I'm like, oh, well, I guess his internet went out. Well, then I looked up at my screen. I looked over at my other screen where the stream was up, and it was just a spinning circle. And then all of a sudden my Discord disconnected and all of that crap, and I'm like, oh, it was our internet that went out. And it wasn't just a, you know, a little quick outage and then right back up. No, it was out for like 5 minutes. So, needless to say, the stream was halted abruptly. I could have restarted it, but when we were... I was going to be done anyway when we got done with that load, so... breaks of the game, first world problems, right? But that did allow me, it was... let's see, 3... almost 4 o'clock when the stream was done. So 3:53 or whatever. about 4:30, I looked at my watch and I'm like, damn, it is almost 60 degrees out. So guess what I did? If you guessed, fired up the motorcycles, you were correct. I actually hadn't topped the tanks off like I normally do prior to winter time, non-riding season, and put some Stabil in the tank, so that's what I did. And man, even though it was like a 5-10 minute ride up to the gas station and back, holy crap, that was, it's what the soul needed. Kind of like this long descent with Jake Brakes. Ty, you have 101,000 pounds of sand behind you, so easy on the curves. Although I don't know what's wrong with Dayton's trailer up here. It's kind of... he may want to get that looked at. Was kind of close. Good Lord, that must have been a little hill or something. That's a little rough to take off.
Turn left.
I missed it last time. Mile High Stadium. So she just stopped f***ing around with the cameras. these that you can't go straight.
Exit left ahead.
Nice.
Go straight.
Is this trucks? Autos. There's no road here. Okay, so then where the hell are trucks supposed to go into? Jesus H, man. Okay, so that sign says trucks enter. Is that not an actual... Okay, that's not an actual freaking place. Awesome. Even better. I'm supposed to turn right here that I can't freaking see. This gate better open. If it doesn't, I guess I'll just back out of here. I supposed to turn here. This road. No, it was apparently the other one, but whatever. This one's not marked, but yet works, so. That little jaunt may have just pushed us into having to sleep.
Turn right.
Thank you. past an actual truck stop you get into is on the other side of the interstate.
50 yards, keep right. Keep right.
Just take this at 40 and freaking roll the damn thing.
Keep left.
Well, almost happened. I was actually joking, but it almost literally happened. Okay, anybody else wanna... Part is I can't sleep. That'll put us at least 4 hours late. As of right now, I've got a 4-minute window. Damn complete stop. and stoplights. I didn't even think of this. So now with the detour and stoplights, we're not making it. On time, that is.
Go straight.
I need this car to figure out what it wants to do. Okay, thank you. And there we go. Oh, and I need to turn right. But not at that stoplight. Okay, good.
Go straight.
And then he turns right. Okay. Whatever. I'll just sit here and wait, I guess. We discovered that.
Go straight.
Thank you.
Turn right.
The blinkers have to speed up too. That's just awesome.
Turn left. After 50 yards, keep left. Keep left. After
holy
50
crap.
Yards, turn left.
I literally turn couldn't left. Press my brake any harder. Yeah, somehow now we're 21 minutes to the negative, so... I don't know. cover that. Really, game?
Go straight.
Feet from that dealership and it won't discover it, but yet if there's a viewpoint, well, you can discover that damn thing about a half a state away. And yes, for those that take every little thing I say seriously, that was a joke. I was stretching it a little bit. Hope we don't fall asleep on one of these curves, because we are out of time. Well, the good news is there's a rest area at Powder River. Up
after 100 yards, turn
okay,
left.
Ty, could you keep the rain selector? Good lord.
Turn left.
Turn left, and it's hard to judge this at night. Okay, yay, I did it. I'm honestly surprised that the screen hasn't went complete black yet. That tells me to go there, but there's a road right here. Is there not? Yes. Okay. So I can't see what the hell is going on. This is an auger, though, that I can drive under. So there's no need to back that. Okay, there isn't. There's a little road right here. Surprise. The screen hasn't gone black yet. Not complaining though. Still managed an excellent, even though I wrecked the piss out of the truck. Love night driving. Okay, a couple of them were braking issues, but Okay, so now I need to figure out how to get to this. I don't know, so I'm just going to spin around here. I mean, it would appear it's right behind me. Smokes. Well, that was interesting. Okay, now it's daytime. Let's take a look at this. Okay, so if I would have come in that way, I could have listened to her. But if I just come in that way, it'd have been a straight in deal. Oh well, live and learn. Already back up to 2.3. I'm really going to have to figure out something to do when we hit 5. Because I haven't figured that out yet. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, episode 121 comes to an end. I'll get the truck fixed before 122, promise. If you made it this far, I appreciate you. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. And don't forget to drop a like on the way out. And until the next one, y'all take care. Bye.